What's good, y'all? Blessings. I am Matthew Cooley. I am here with my beautiful wife, Emma, aka Faustina, y'all. Faustina Cooley. But anyway, we are doing our daily devotion. We are on June 29th with Pastor Gina. Hopefully you guys been in tune. You've been subscribing. You've been blessed by the messages that's going forth. Yes. So we got another blessing for you guys, another devotion. My wife is going to read it, and we're just going to give you guys some insight and what we believe will be a blessing to you guys.
Yeah, amen. So June 29th, put me first in your life. When you choose worship over entertainment, when you choose scripture over a fiction novel, when you choose prayer over chatting with friends, it moves my heart. It really moves my heart. When you seek first the kingdom of God, you will find the kingdom of God and your Father who sits on the throne. You will find the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Don't seek some supernatural encounter. Seek the kingdom and you will find the supernatural. Choose worship, choose scripture, choose prayer, choose us, for we have chosen you. Aww. So some scriptures that we have with that is Matthew 6:33, Deuteronomy 4:29, and 1 Corinthians 13:11. So you want me to share those scriptures? Okay. Mm-hmm. So I'll start with the first one. Matthew 6:33. It says, but seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Deuteronomy 4:29. But if from there you seek the Lord your God, you will find him if you seek him with all of your heart and with all of your soul. And then 1 Corinthians 13:11. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. So when I read that, I thought of like a real life example of putting God first, right? Mm-hmm. So sometimes in the morning, I like to have like my worship, my car ride, you know, some of my most intimate moments are in the car with God because I have a long commute. And sometimes like I'll start getting into like deep worship, right? And then I'll be like crying, like, thank you, Lord, yes, and this and that, da, da, da. And then my phone rings. I'll be like thinking. And then sometimes I'll stop and answer the phone. Mm-hmm. And then be on the phone the rest of the car ride, you know? And when it said, choose me first, mm-hmm. I was like, yo. How many times do I not choose God first? Mm-hmm. You get what I'm saying? Like I might be in the middle of something with him, mm-hmm. or like my phone rang, like, you know, the kids might come. I might get an email. I might get a message on Facebook. And then it's like, I put God on hold, mm-hmm. go do that. And sometimes I don't come back. Mm-hmm. I don't come back, you know? Wow. And it just like, corrected me, like, mm-hmm. you know, it said that choose them first because they chose us first, yeah. you know, mm-hmm. and it's like, Lord, help me to choose you first more, mm-hmm. because I always, you know, want you to put me first, go above and beyond for me, yeah. you know what I mean, meet all of my expectations, mm-hmm. exceedingly abundantly, like, mm-hmm. you know, and God is like supposed to be your boo thing, you feel me? But it's like you putting him last, you know. I have a thing about my husband, like, what if we were having date night and my phone ring and I completely leave you and disappear? Wow. Like, how much would that hurt?
Left out.
Like how much would that hurt you, you know? Yeah, and then it's like, well, how do you think God feels when we do stuff like that to him? So, you know, I thank you for that reminder, you know, to seek him first.
Absolutely. I mean, I love how you mentioned me in a relationship aspect of it, because that's one of the biggest things I get out of it is the relational aspect of it. Sometimes we look at Christianity, us following Jesus and things like that, and we just put it in a category, in a box of just religion. You get what I'm saying? But it's more than just a religion, it's a relationship. You get what I'm saying? The Bible says that Jesus came to restore which was lost, and that's to have a true relationship in a communion with God, not just so it could be by rules and regulations and laws and, yeah. and by a set rules. You get what I'm saying? So I love on here where it talks about, let me read what it say. It says, my heart It says, it really moves my heart when you seek me first, and you will find the kingdom of God, your Father who sits on, you will find the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. But I like on here where we was talking is putting more of the emphasis of it moving God's heart when we spend time with him. And I liken it unto a relationship because it's not just about the big encounters that we have, like every single night gotta be date night, romance night. It's the little things every day. It's waking up, acknowledging you, babe, how you doing? Good morning. How are you feeling? Would you like to pray together? Like, just acknowledging you as a person versus every time you wake up, I'm on my phone and I don't have nothing to say to you. You off to work. I never said, babe, be safe. None of that. I ain't kiss you goodbye. I let you go off to work. And then I'm on Instagram posting pictures. I'm on Facebook posting statuses and what's on your heart. And I ain't even mention you. You know what I'm saying? You know how you go on Facebook. It's like, share what's on your mind. And I ain't even mention you. You're going to feel some kind of way because we have a bond, a covenant, a relationship, and I've yet to acknowledge you. And even on Facebook, I'm not even sharing anything about you. Am I even on your mind? How do I even feel about you? So it's the same thing with the Lord. You know, we have to train ourselves to be godly. That's all. Let me pull that scripture up right quick. She got like mad pictures in her phone. I'm like, yo, you cannot bounce back and forth in this woman's phone. But hold up. Is that right? Okay. That's 1 Timothy 4:7. It talks about train yourself to be godly. For physical training is of some value, but godliness has value for all things. And it's like, it's not a human or a natural nature to just wake up and want to seek the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, to seek the kingdom first. That's you having to discipline your flesh. You having to discipline yourself to be godly. And once you keep doing that, just like exercising, which was the example, you would get used to it. Imagine you not working out for a long time. I don't know when the last time some of y'all been to the gym, but you thinking about the gym is tiring. The first day you go, you finally get the confidence to go, and then you go, and now you super tired on your first day, and you want to give up. You got to keep pressing past that. You got to keep pressing past the, I'm going to look like this in one day. Like, it's a day-by-day commitment. And it doesn't matter how hard you go the first day. It doesn't matter how long you spend time with God day one or how long you pray. It's about consistently. God is looking for consistency. You get what I'm saying? Think about our relationship, our marriage. You get what I'm saying? A marriage is a covenant relationship. Yeah. And we have a covenant with the Lord. He'll never leave us nor forsake us. All right. Anything you wanted to share off of that?
Just when you were talking, I was thinking about consistency. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because when I was sharing some stuff with you earlier, you know, I won't go into detail, obviously. But the thing that I was pointing out to you, it's like, you know what? Even though these people might do this, it's their consistency. Mm-hmm. Do you get what I'm saying? So it's like, I think of like Peter, right? Mm-hmm. So he was, you know, an apostle of Jesus Christ, you know? And it was like, God was like correcting him often, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But Peter was always consistent, you get what I'm saying? Like, he was always consistent, you know? Mm-hmm. And I feel like, you know, like God's not necessarily like looking at us to like kick us down, do you get what I'm saying? But I think that he wants the consistency in a relationship. Absolutely. And what needs to be worked on will be worked on. Absolutely. We will deal with that, you know?
Absolutely.
Like, and I think that, you know, sometimes it's not like the grandioso things once in a blue. Absolutely. You feel me? But it's the small things daily, you know? So, amen.
They call that the honeymoon phase, where everything just glitz and glam and all that kind of stuff. Yeah. And every night is like a movie, date night and all that. It come a time where it start being intentional. Yeah. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. And I just want to give you this scripture as well. Joshua chapter 24:15. And I love it. This is the NIV version. It says, but if serving the Lord seems ungodly, or excuse me, hold on.
Undesirable. My scripture though.
Where is that, right here? Okay. Yeah. It say, but if serving the Lord seems undesirable, then choose this day for yourself who you will serve. And I always found that scripture interesting because just like a relationship, just like a parenthood, just like work, not every single time do you feel led or do you feel encouraged or empowered to spend time with God. And sometimes you just want to sleep in bed, and sometimes you just not beat. And the Lord already knows that, but he's telling us like, okay, now you got to pick and choose that day. We know you chose me. You were super encouraged yesterday, but now today I need you to keep that same energy even though you don't feel like it, because the Lord always plays his part. He never take a day off. He's always watching us. His hand is always on us. He's always protecting protecting us from the enemy. And the Lord never takes a day off. Never do he ever sleep or slumber. So he's always doing a job. So the issue with us and God is not really what God is doing. It's really is on our part.
Yeah.
And what was the last scripture? That goes to, what was the last scripture? It says, you put your childish things away. That was 1 Corinthians 13. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. But when I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me.
Oh, you know what that reminds me of? It's like, say when you're like in an immature relationship, right? Okay. So like, say when you're in like an immature relationship, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like the second you guys fight, you leave, you break up, like all this, bye. Like, I'm out of here. I'm not talking to you. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And once you get matured in the relationship, you know not to leave. You get what I'm saying? You might talk, work it out, have different strategies, solutions, etc. You know?
Yeah.
And so I love how it says, like, you know, like he chooses us every day, you know? Yeah. So it's like his love is so intentional.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, I choose you, like, no matter what, you know? And it's like, help us to choose you like that as well. You get what I'm
Absolutely,
saying?
Yeah.
Like, let us choose you like that, you know? Because everything isn't always going to be like rainbows and butterflies with God. You get what I'm saying?
Amen.
Just like things aren't always rainbows and butterflies in relationships, you know?
Amen.
But you learn how to weather the good and the bad.
Mm-hmm.
But you always, like, put the relationship first. You get what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Like, put that first, you know? And, like, you sow into it. You get what I'm saying? So then at times when you need it, you can pull from it, you know?
Absolutely.
And you'll I think that it will also make you more secure in your relationship as well.
Absolutely.
When you put that time in.
Yep.
Because I know, like, you know, like, when I know that we spend a lot of time together, you get what I'm saying? If you got to fly to Miami, I'm cool. Because I know me and my boo thing been spending time together. You feel me? But it's like, if we've been arguing the last 8 weeks and you got to go work in Miami, I'm like, I'm going too. You know what I mean? But not really. But you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, it makes you more secure in the relationship too. So then it's like, you know, when you're spending time with God, you know, when you're like, Papa, you going to show up? You already feel confident he going to show up. Because, you know, you've been spending time with your boo. Like, you've been spending time with God, you know? So, amen.
Spending time with God is your boo. Us men more relate to him as a father, but amen. All right, so you want to read the closing prayer?
Yes.
And then I'll just close this out.
So, amen. It says, I sense that you are calling me to put aside childish things and enter into a new level of your glory.
Mm-hmm.
And I say yes to your heart. I say yes to your will and yes to your ways. I say yes to worship and prayer. I say yes to the supernatural life you want me to live.
Amen. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord God, we just come to you asking that you will forgive us
yes,
and
Lord.
Cleanse us of unrighteousness. You said in your word to seek the kingdom first in your righteousness, Lord God. And then continue on. But Lord God, we ask that you will forgive us of any unrighteousness,
yes,
Lord
sir.
God, where we began to do things which was right in our own eyesight, Lord God, where we leaned on our own strength, our own understanding, and we did not acknowledge you in all of our ways, Lord God. We ask that you will forgive us for choosing social media over you, for choosing the radio, the news, Lord God, for choosing friends and opinions and just so many things that would just cause distraction, Lord God. We ask that you will forgive us, Lord God. I'm praying that you will soften our heart, Father
yes,
God,
sir.
So that you will put a fresh desire in us, Lord, that we would draw closer to you. You said in your word, if we draw nigh unto you, then you would draw nigh unto us, Lord
yes.
God. I pray that everybody that's made it this far through the devotion, Lord God, that you would ignite a fire within their bosom,
yes,
ignite
sir.
A fire within their spirit to seek you first in your righteousness, Lord God. Give them the grace and strength, Lord God, to press when they don't feel like it, Lord God, when it seems undesirable. Let them pick and choose this day, Lord God. But most importantly, let them choose you, Father God. For those, Father God, that may be new in the faith, Lord God, and we're babes in Christ, Lord, I pray that you would speak to us. Let us move on to maturity, Lord God, so that we may put the childish things away, Father God, so that we can walk in holiness, so that we can walk looking for your wisdom, so that we can
yes,
walk
God.
Seeking you, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray, Lord God. Let serving you be fun, Lord. Lord God. Your ways is better, Lord God. Your thoughts is better. Yes. Your wisdom is better, Father God. Spending time with you is fun. It brings peace. It brings joy. It brings comfort. It brings clarity, Lord God. And there's no other better place to be, Lord God, than it is, Father God, in your presence, Lord God. So draw us back to that place. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You guys be blessed.
Amen. Love you.